What's up, everybody? This is a video that I've been meaning to do for a while. I was just basically trying to find the right time for it, and the timing feels pretty good right now, and you'll basically see why later on in this video. But yeah, this is going to focus on my favorite video games of all time. This was really not an easy list to choose, so it's really just going to be a top five, because once I got beyond five, it was just really tough to try to figure that out, you know, because I've played so many great games over the years, and I've owned so many systems. I've owned well over a dozen systems in my lifetime, and you know, going all the way back to the first system I had, which was the NES. So yeah, I've owned a lot of systems. I've played hundreds of games, and it was very tough to do this list. So yeah, I'm just gonna keep it at a top five, but I am gonna kick things off with an honorable mention. So as an honorable mention, I gotta give a big shout out to my favorite game of 2017, which was Resident Evil 7. This deep into a series, you really don't expect a game to, you know, really deliver greatness, but they really did with this game, and I think it was much needed for gamers overall, especially with the cancellation of Silent Hills, which was a big disappointment, because that PT, you know, teaser demo was just awesome. And I wish I still had that saved, but I did have to do like a hard reboot on my system. So yeah, I don't have that anymore. But yeah, regardless, Resident Evil 7 was really a great game. A lot of horror games just kind of divulge into a shooting gallery eventually, but this game, even though it had a little bit of that, overall it still stayed true to the horror genre. You definitely had to manage your items and everything, and it kind of kept you on your toes. Pretty solid story overall as well. So yeah, I really enjoyed Resident Evil 7, and I got to play the DLC at some point. Now we're going to go ahead and get into my top five, starting off, of course, with number five. For number five, I got to give it to DJ Hero 2. I absolutely love this game. I've played it so much. I've worn out a couple of turntables. What I really like about this game is it has such a great soundtrack that it actually got me listening to a lot of music that I normally probably wouldn't even bother to check out. And there's just so much great music in the game. And then it had real DJs as well. And it even had RZA. You know, you see RZA here, which a lot of people don't think of him as a DJ, but of course that is part of his skill set. And yeah, I just really love this game. It was just really fun. And like I said, I appreciate that it got me listening to some artists that I just really didn't even know much about, you know. And it is unfortunate that, you know, the DLC for the game, I'll probably never be able to play that again. But I do hope to play, you know, the original game again at some point. DJ Hero 2, and then it does include the tracks for part 1 as well, I think. I did want you all to see here that, yes, I still do have a turntable. As a matter of fact, I actually have two turntables for the game, because at some point, it's kind of funny, like the PlayStation 3 is actually still somewhat popular. You know, those last gen systems are still somewhat popular, so there's been price drops, but I still hope to find one maybe even cheaper, because I really would like to get a PlayStation 3, mainly so I can play DJ Hero 2 again, and then also the fourth game on my list, which I am about to go ahead and get to the fourth game here. And this one, I believe it was on PlayStation 3. I could be mistaken. It could be a PlayStation 2 game. Regardless, this is one I hope I get to play again in the future. And that game is Burnout 3. Now, you talk about just pure fun. This game really is all about that. It really took racing to a new level for me, because it's not just about the racing. It's not just about getting in first place. Of course, that's still a goal, but it's also about making your opponents crash. And that just never gets old. It's just so much fun. And they even have a mode that's all about crashing, where you actually crash into traffic and you try to cause as much damage as possible. Now, you know, this is all good in a video game, of course. You know, we'll take out the real world aspects of crashes. I know that's negative, but in terms of a game, it was just pure fun. Really loved the soundtrack to it and everything, even though I think I played this on Xbox and I would just play music over it. But regardless, great game all around. We're already on to number three. Number three for me, this was, at one point, I was really thinking of it as my favorite game of all time, number one, but then I kind of put some more thought into it and things kind of turned around some. But still, I absolutely love Red Dead Redemption. I think it's one of the best open world games ever made, and it's kind of surprising because of the setting. You would think with the Western setting that it would be kind of tough to fill it with things to do, but I was never bored playing this game. There was always something going on. I liked, all the little side missions and everything, and I also liked all the different little mini games you could play within the world. Like they had, you could play poker, you could play liar's dice, which I wasn't familiar with that until this game. Horseshoes, you know, which sounds real simplistic, but is actually kind of fun to play sometimes. And like even as you're just moving around the world, you can stop stop crimes going on and all sorts of things, even though you're not a lawman. I mean, you're pretty much a outlaw in a way, but still, it just had so much going on. And then the music in the game is amazing. There's a moment towards the end of the game where you're riding off to complete basically your main quest, and the music cue just comes in, and like the time of day, I don't know if it's like this for everybody, but for me, the time of day was like, I think it was like sunset, or either the sun was coming up, but it just looked beautiful. Like the skyboxes in the game are amazing, and then this music just came in out of nowhere, and it was like just emotionally impactful. And even the end of the game, it did not end the way that I thought it would. Like if you played this game, you know that there's a pretty good surprise towards the end. There's like this whole epilogue type section, which I just had never seen done before in a game, and it was all handled really well. And then on top of that, Red Dead Redemption had some amazing DLC. They had this Undead Nightmare DLC, which actually had a story to it, which was very cool. It wasn't just that they slapped zombies into the game, which, I mean, that's kind of common now for DLC. There are a lot of games that have like zombies in them, you know, especially as DLC, but it wasn't just about that. It was really fleshed out, and it even had like I think you could go and try to round up like the four horses of the apocalypse or something. There were like mythical creatures in it and everything, you know, just different things to find. It, like I said, it was really fleshed out. It felt like a whole game almost unto itself. Not quite as long as the original game, of course. It was much shorter than that, but still very entertaining. So yeah, Red Dead Redemption all around was awesome, and I really cannot wait to see the sequel. Now we're up to number two here. At number two, I definitely have to give it to The Last of Us. This game was phenomenal, really phenomenal. It just completely blew me away. I didn't get to play this on PlayStation 3 because my PlayStation 3, after having it for many years, it finally did burn out on me, and it may have been my fault, it may have been just the way that I had the system set up. But my PlayStation 3 burned out, and I was really bummed because I really did want to check this game out. But luckily, they did the remaster for PlayStation 4, and that's how I played it. And yeah, I'm really glad they remastered it. The graphics were amazing, but it was really so much more than that. It was really the emotion of the story between the main characters, Joel and Ellie. They just had just amazing chemistry as characters. And this game, from the jump, from the opening, it just had emotional impact to it, and that really carried throughout, but it also still had a lot of humor as well. This is another game that has some very impressive DLC, which really fleshed out the character of Ellie even more, and again, very emotionally impactful. And just to see teens really acting like teens, behaving like teenagers despite this scenario that they're in, yeah, it was very interesting, just very emotionally impactful. I played the main story, I think I played it through two or three times, and then the Left Behind DLC, I only played that once, honestly, because even though I really appreciated it, I was almost like emotionally exhausted with the game by that point, because it is very impactful, and I really expect a lot, you know, from the follow-up. And then what was even more surprising about this game was the multiplayer. The online multiplayer was amazing. I did not expect that. I really got into it, and I played this a lot. I mean, a whole lot. And I actually had some really good gameplays with it too. I didn't always do amazing with it. You know, I'll be honest, I wasn't always amazing with it, but I had some really great games. Even had a couple of games where I ended up being the last person on my team and I clutched up, and that just felt awesome. I remember the first time that I ended up being the last team member left, and I think I was still against at least three of the other team, or it might have been the whole team. It got my heart racing. It was really intense, and that game is always that way. It's just a really intense game, really enjoyable. I liked that you have to craft items and everything on the fly. It just really keeps you on your toes. What was also cool about it, this is something that Naughty Dog did that was really intelligent, is that they made it so that you could basically interact with your teammates and communicate with them, and you didn't have to be on mic to be a team player, which I definitely appreciated because I don't like to play on mic usually. I usually like to, you know, have music going, or I might have a YouTube video playing on my laptop while I'm playing a game. So I definitely appreciated that, you know. And the only reason I'm not still playing it to this day is because it did have some bugginess at times, which could be annoying, but overall, still great game. And now we are down to my number one favorite game of all time. I definitely put a lot of thought into this, and there's just one game that stuck with me. It's kind of a recent game, but it really stuck to me, and I just could not get it out of my mind. And you know, I still play it sometimes, actually. And it is yet another PlayStation exclusive here. No hate against Xbox. I played Xbox too. Like I said, I've owned many systems, but yeah, Bloodborne is just so good. It is just so good. Like, if you have not had a chance to play this game and you do have a PlayStation 4, you might want to check it out. I know there's possibly a sequel on the way, which if there is, I'm going to put so much time into it because I put so much time into the first game. And this is my first time playing this type of game. I didn't play any of the Dark Souls games, and it's made by the same company. But and I did eventually try Dark Souls 3. I was not crazy about it. It's really the mechanics of Bloodborne that really got me into it. How you there's no shields. I mean, there is one shield, but it's basically like a joke within the game. It really makes you be offensive, and because you can get some health back if you've been hurt, and then you stay offensive, you strike back your opponents, you know, strike back the enemies, you can get a little health back. And you can also use guns. They're really not so much to cause harm, but really to parry enemies. It's just a very intelligent offensive system, and it just works so well. And then the lore and the story behind everything, I like how it's not told out to you word for word. You really have to kind of work with other people, you know, that it has this great community of people that kind of share ideas and they share theories and everything, and have kind of helped to figure out the story behind this game. And that's something else I like about it too. The community really helped each other also in finding items, and also learning how to deal with the bosses, learning different strategies and everything. It's a very community driven game. And the main thing that I do with this game now is I still will hop into the game and I'll help out other people fighting in the chalice dungeons, or, you know, people that are taking on bosses in the main game. And I love that they have that option that you can do that. You can hop in and help out other players, and it's very rewarding. It's to me, it's almost as rewarding as, you know, fighting the boss for yourself the first time. It's a really good feeling to help out others. And yeah, that's what I've mainly been doing with this game lately. As a matter of fact, I did that just a couple of nights ago. And it's cool to see that there are still people playing this game. This game has been out, I forget, 2 or 3 years or so. But yeah, it still has a great community going. Still just a phenomenal game. And like I said, if you have not checked it out, you really should. So yeah, that does it for my favorite games of all time. And you see here on the screen, I'm sharing something else with you, because Loot Crate, the latest Loot Crate was kind of an interesting one. It felt almost like a stock dump at the end of the year or something. Everybody got a random item, and the item that I got here was this very interesting Halo figure, which if you know Halo, then you know that this is representative of the Flood, which to me is one of the most annoying aspects of Halo. And I did like the Halo games overall. I played 1, 2, and 3. I'm not sure if I played anything beyond that. But yeah, the Flood just always kind of aggravated me. But yeah, this figure looks crazy. And at first I was like, what in the world is this? But then it hit me what was going on there. So yeah, I think it's good detail for what it is. You know, representing the Flood is definitely very true to that. But I don't think it quite fits into my collection. So, gonna do a little quick giveaway here. And by the way, the box is not perfect. That is the way that it came, you know, but I don't think that's a big deal, because I think if you really like this figure, you know, you probably take it out anyway and check it out up close and, you know, have it on display and everything. And you might even want to display it with the upcoming new Halo Pop figures, which, yeah, there are some vaulted Halo figures, but yeah, there's some new ones on the way that I think are gonna look pretty impressive. But yeah, and also, by the way, Loot Crate has some other Halo figures that I think are pretty impressive as well. And they actually have the stands where they can connect together for certain figures, which is a cool touch. But yeah, if you want a chance to get this Halo figure, what I need you to do is in the comments, and just, let's keep it simple. Just give me your top five favorite video games of all time, or you could do your top five recent favorite video games if it's too tough to do an all-time list. It's really up to you. Please don't put anything extra, though, because I'm pretty sure, you know, I'm going to have a good number of comments to read. So basically, just keep it simple for me. So give me your top five favorite video games in a numbered list. And if you want a chance to win this figure, then put an X at the end of your list after your last item. And that'll let me know that you want to be entered. So again, give me your top five favorite video games. And then after the list, put an X. Keep it real simple. And if you want a chance to win, and this is something I'm going to make a requirement also for all of my future giveaways, the next Funko News videos, not the last one, but the next Funko News video, which will go up this weekend, you also need to share that on social media. It could be Facebook, Twitter, you could shout it out on Instagram, however you want to do it. Share that next Funko News video some way on social media. And I will need to have proof of that once you win. You know, if you are the winner, I will need to be able to see proof of that. So make sure you share it in a way that you can prove it later on in case you win. Don't tag me in anything right now. Please don't do that. You know, just if you win, then you will have to be able to prove that you shared that video. So again, that'll be the next Funko News video, the one going up this weekend. So again, that's how you enter. Give me your list. Put an X at the end of it, and then make sure you share the next Funko News video on social media. And I'm going to give it, I'm not going to put a date to this necessarily. I'll kind of see how feedback goes on the video. And once the comments start to slow up, then I will do a drawing, and we'll see who wins this Halo figure. But yeah, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed, you know, hearing my top five favorite video games, and also, you know, my honorable mention. And if you paid attention to the background throughout this video, then you know that there are some other games that have stood out to me over the years. Yeah, definitely look forward though to checking out your feedback. Oh, by the way, if you want to give me a quick reason why each of the games on your list really stands out to you, that would be cool. But like I said, just don't be super wordy with it, just because I know I'm going to have a lot to read in the comments, and I do want to be able to get to all of them and actually give them some attention. But yeah, if you want to give me a quick reason why you really liked each game, that would be cool. But yeah, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will talk to you all again real soon.